Yo people, it's been a while. Yeah, more reason I'm excited to be on the show today. You know, we've had some we had to get some things sorted for the smooth running of the show. It's why we've been away, so we're back and we're here to serve you better.
If you want no person, you no go first person. Yo. I know they sick. You won't give me medicine. I got money, yo. You won't help me spend my money. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy myself. I'm a do it, yeah. Let me do it like I do it, how I do it. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy.
Allow me, yo.
Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy myself. Allow me to enjoy myself.
Yeah.
Oh mama,
body that.
Oh mama,
body that.
If you know what make you happy, something go do you, something go do you.
Yeah.
Water go show you,
thunder
go yam on you. Something go do you, something go do you. Water go show you, something go.
Big small snap.
Don't forget that I'm your girl Oduayo, your host on Talk with Oduayo. Yeah, so today we continue from our last episode of The Life of a Single. I have some persons sharing how it feels as a single in their environment, more like survival as a single. So enjoy.
Sometimes I tend to feel lonely. Yes, tend to feel lonely. But what really helps me most time is that because I have my reason why I'm single for the time being, which is valid and of essence. So that actually makes me feel a little better whenever the moodiness creeps in and all that. And another thing which I always do to avoid the alone feeling is that most time I tend to spend time with others. That is most of my free time. I tend to spend time with others. It might be hanging out, it might be just communicating, a long communication, maybe on voice call, or eating up via chat and all of those stuff. So I tend to spend time with others too in my spare time. So that also helps to avoid that alone feeling. Another thing which I do most times to get out of my mood whenever I'm being caught up in that moodiness of being alone and all of those stuff, feeling lonely, and anytime that eats me, like I'm always, my spirit being is always very low. Like I can be very unproductive at that time, and But once I'm able to bounce back, I always do give myself a nice treat. I do that a lot. I give myself a nice treat. On days like that, I just go out. If I'm home, I go out to get stuff and prepare a very nice meal for myself, a very rich meal for myself. Like, it's just like having a date with myself. So I do that a lot. I think that have helped me cope with the alone feeling. So that's what I just do basically.
Hi everyone. So talking about how I actually, you know, I'm currently living with this societal stigma of being single, because that's what is happening around these days. People will be like, oh hi, what's up, are you single, are you married, are you engaged? Like, it still happened to me today. I took a cab and the guy was like, hi, okay, so my name is blah blah blah, and it goes by, are you married, are you single, or are you engaged? And hearing that, I'm like, okay, here we go again. I'm like, no, I'm not married and I'm not engaged. I'm single, yes, but I'm not ready to mingle. And I feel like these questions, they're being asked every day. In fact, I'll go home to see my parents. You see, maybe you hear from all these, your aunties or uncles, be like, when are you getting married? You're still single. Where's your boyfriend? What's he doing? Why has he not proposed? And the funny thing is, do people realize that sometimes you just want to be single? It's not everybody that wants to just rush into getting married. I don't feel like we all should rush into getting married. We should all take our time. Like they say, you know, we all have different time. Your time cannot be my time. So you cannot use somebody's time to judge. But Nigerians generally, this society that we are in, they will judge you with another person's time. And it's crazy, because if you allow them to judge you, my dear, you will be misled. And that's how you will go into a relationship that before you know it, you're already out. And that's the honest truth. I have a couple of friends that they are currently in this boat. And it's really, really, really crazy. Because at the end of the day, you try to do all these things because you want to please the fact that, okay, you're hearing this, you're hearing that, because you want to block them out. But at the end of the day, it's still you that will be inside that marriage. And when you cannot take it anymore, you come out of it. So now tell me, what was the point? So practically, the only way I've actually survived, or I'm surviving this old societal stigma, is that I do me. I try to stay on the path that I want and I just follow it. I don't allow anybody to put me under unnecessary pressure. Once you come and you start talking, you know, I just tell you plain blank, oh, very soon. If you cannot wait for the very soon, allow you, move to the angle that you want to move to. Go to the next person. Because we all have to just be careful. And we all have to be very, 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 very prayerful. That's the honest truth. Because if it is not time for you to do something and you do it, my dear, they say this, I hear this thing which says, when you rush into something, you will rush out. So if you follow the crowd, it's that same crowd you follow when you're coming out. So I just feel like the fact that so many people are out there and they are dealing with how to survive this stigma, it's just basically knowing what you want and stand firm. If you're not ready to go into a relationship that will lead to a marriage, just stay on your own. And if you're ready to do it and you know it's the time that you want specifically, if you feel it's not the time, don't even bother. Don't stress yourself. If you're doing something because of societal stigma, then I'm sorry, it's wrong. That means you're not following what you want. You're not going according to the time you want. You're going with the time other people have chosen for you. And it doesn't even make sense. So you following your own path is just the best. Like, try just to do what you and your partner want. I've heard of different scenarios whereby so many things. Let me just stop right there.
First of all, when we say someone is single, obviously we're coming from the angle that the person has not married yet. So some very quick relatable topics or something that you can, you know, readily go, the words that you can readily, you know, use with someone that is single is, you'd assume the person is lonely, you assume the person is alone, and you know, they get into situations where the people that are in a supposedly perfect relationship are peppering the single one, so pepper them gang and all of that. Anyway, so to talk about living as a single, I'd like to touch on the advantages first. One of the advantages, so now I'm speaking about myself in a bit and then in a general tone. So some of the advantages would be level-headedness. When I say level-headedness, I mean that, you know, there's just this way that you're just, you know, just light, no, not light-headed, but, you know, level-headed means, you know, you're just calm and you're not in some unnecessary pressure that your partner may have placed you in sometimes, you know. I've heard some ridiculous reasons sometimes, you know, maybe because you had gone a day without calling, and then some people would just bring up some kind of issues, you know. So first of all, one of the great advantage living as a single, I'd say level-headedness. You know, you're just calm, you're super calm, you're not going to be putting any kind of pressure or any kind of emotional blackmail or, you know, unnecessarily, right? So another advantage would be control. You know, you kind of just have control about how you want to spend your day, you have control about what you want to do, what you want to eat, what you don't want to eat. And I say that because, so you know, when two people come together, there just seems to be expectations, right? There's an expectations the other person expects from you, and yeah, maybe there's some expectations that you also expect from the person. So I think if this maybe if it gets overboard, or even if it doesn't, the fact that there's some kind of expectations, you know, it just sets some kind of go with the control part free. Again, I think this is not a one-size-fits-all, because some relationship don't exactly put you in a prison, right? So I mean, not all. So, but advantage is that you're free. You can just live your life however you want it, you know, and you don't just find yourself entangled into situations and all of that. Most importantly, the last one is, I'd say that you learn to be independent, right? You probably just learn to keep your company of yourself. When you're alone, you're not exactly miserable, you know, you're just comfortable anyway. When you're alone, you can spend time by yourself, you can go do some cool stuff. Sometimes I just so I really like burgers, so I tend to want to just check out some really cool burger spots and just, you know, sit down, buy burgers and just eat. Well, there's nothing that has advantages that doesn't have disadvantages. So for disadvantages, I'd say loneliness, you know, the importance of having someone that you really, really love, or someone that you really, really care for. You know, when you two people have this bond, have this, when you have this, you know, this really cool relationship, it can be overlooked. I'm not going to lie, but then, so when you exactly don't have someone, when you're single, you're going to be lonely. you can find yourself lonely most of the time, aside the fact that maybe you're just jumping from one, you know, person to another. If you actually you know not in any relationship or in any kind of short-term stuffs stuff is not a word, short-term relationship or entanglement, you get a bit lonely sometimes. Yeah, so you just find yourself wishing that you had somebody to share some time with and all of that. Well, you said stigma of the site. Yeah, I think that is there, right? Especially when people are getting some certain age, people tend to look at you like, what is wrong with you? But then, not that something's actually wrong with you. This things, I want to speak on it so much, but I think sometimes we're just the architect of our own fate, misfortune, or lack thereof. Because, you know, some people just have this idea of some prince in shiny armor or Cinderella princess, so they're just always stacking the odds against themselves. You know, they have this idea of someone that's super super perfect. There's nothing like that, really. So yeah, so you tend to be alone, and people in society just tend to look at you like, especially when you get to a certain age, you just look at you like, oh, what's wrong with this person? Why hasn't he or she gotten married yet, and all of that. another disadvantage would be weather for two. So, you know, when it's raining, this comes usually at some specific weather. When it's some specific weather, people just talk about weather for two. You know, that it's raining and, you know, it's cold, and you're just supposed to have someone by your side. All of that, you guys are cuddling or taking some hot beverage and all of that. So yeah, I think that usually that period, you know, you tend to maybe feel like, oh, you'd want to have someone as you're cuddling right now and all of that. So yeah, that's also comes in. And another one is companionship, which I think I've touched in everything that I've said, but to just use COVID-19 for example, I mean, that period some people would have been in their houses for months, and you know, they were just by themselves. It would have been terrible for some people, you know. So if they had had a companion, even if they're not exactly together, but you know, you could see that they are usually either video calling or voice calling, and they're just, you know, keeping in touch, keeping themselves sane in that period and all of that. So companionship, yeah, that's one thing you don't have when you're single. And lastly, which is the most important thing side of not having someone when you're single, is sharing memories. You know, when you have someone, when you visit some really cool places, you guys have you guys make memories, and you can sit down sometime and just, you know, relive such memory and laugh, smile, you know, hug and all of that. So yeah, sharing memories is also important. So yeah, and when you're single, you know, there's this phrase, this joke that goes around, that's last mugwala maje breakfast. So yeah, I wouldn't say it's a bad thing. I think that at the end of the day, I would be an advocate for people to get into a relationship when they're actually ready. It's almost like when you're getting married, right? So I would say people should get into a relationship when they're really, really ready. At the end of the day, it's a choice. Well, for some, if it's a choice, if you want to be that way because you're still trying to figure out yourself, it's fine. And may we all be happy, joyful, and may we find the person that we can share this joyfulness and happiness with. Thank you.
So stigmatization is a sad but true reality for any single person. And the reason is, we live in a society where people strive to get married just because they need to attain some certain level of relevance in the society. They want to feel comfort, they want to feel secured. That's the mindset, that's the societal norm that over time we've created for ourselves. And as a single person, you have to battle with going along with the society that has a different mindset from you, because you start getting peer pressure, you start getting unsolicited advice from strangers, you start getting family pressure, you start getting even pressure from your religious leaders, and then they start asking you the question, the general question they ask all singles: when are you getting married? Are you not old enough? It's good to marry early, you know, all those things. And honestly, it puts single people in a spot. And as a matter of fact, you also deal with rejection. I've had cases where I want to rent an apartment and the landlord tells me we don't rent apartments to bachelors because we feel that they are irresponsible. So it's crazy the level of battle you have to deal with on a daily basis as a single person. It's just terrible. It's terrible. So over time, I have created a different mindset for myself. And that mindset is, I tell myself that I can achieve everything I want to achieve in life, regardless of my marital status. And when I get, confrontations from people about, when am I going to get married, I just tell them when the time is right. That's the sentence I use, and then I ignore every other thing. Now, it might not necessarily work for everybody. I just feel that you have to eventually find a way to balance yourself up so that you can comfortably live a good life, even if the society does not accept you. You have to be able to accept yourself, know that you are good for yourself and by yourself, and find a way to just, go by life until eventually you find the right partner or you don't.
It's not easy, honestly. It is not easy, because sometimes you would even get so depressed that, okay, what's happening and all and everything. Like I said initially, I think prayer is very important, and I don't know, I just feel like prayer is important, and also family background also matters. Like I want to believe I'm one of the luckiest, or I'm one of the blessed people on earth, because my parents, they don't stress me. Like, it's so funny that at my age, I feel like they should have actually popped the question. But then, I'm happy they haven't. Because these are things that really go a long way. And these are things that push people into the wrong relationship, whether we like it or not. Because some people don't even know how far words go. Words are very powerful, and the way you say it or the way you just drop it on people, it goes a very long way. You can say something to somebody and the person is already thinking about their life. They're already depressed, and before you know it, the person is already doing what they're not supposed to do. So I'm just really happy, because the best thing my parents have ever done, one of the best things they've done for me, is not putting me under that societal pressure of, when are you getting married? Why are you not saying anything? Why have you not introduced us to someone? And, blah, blah, blah. Instead, you just pray for me and, tell me that you find your flesh of flesh, your bone of bone, your best friend and all, which I really appreciate. That's why I say, like, I'm so grateful to God for having them as a parent. Because if you're not being pressured from inside, trust me, societal pressure, the outside pressure, would not even matter to you in any way.
Surviving as a single person is quite hard because of the social stigma from friends and family and from acquaintances. They kind of look at you like, is this person serious with his life? Like, why are you not in a relationship? Don't you know your age? or do you plan on being a poop or whatever? So it's not something easy for a guy like me, and I also tend to find support system, and at that point in time when you actually need it, there is none. So it makes someone feel weak or so, but surviving it, just being focused, planning, knowing what one wants and going for it. Because whenever you're in this singlehood type of thing, then people that are in a relationship tend to, why not go for this person? Why not go for the other person that are not up to your standard? Standard not that maybe your physical specs or what you want mentally or physically or emotionally from a person. Then different sets of people come and all that. So being focused, being legit with what you want has been kind of my help. And having a guide mentally, following things that reading, studying, focusing on my career, building myself, has kind of helped me in the way to overcome or to continually survive this single. But it's not something easy for a guy like me. It's kind of hard, but we keep pushing. And that's all I can say. We keep pushing. And one day, we'll get there. That's the plan. Oh, God willing.
I must confess, it's been a great time doing this again. I missed this session of doing this over and over again. So yeah, guys, I'd like to announce that the next show will hold in 2 Sundays time, unlike how we normally have it to be every Sunday. Okay, so this is just one of the strategies of having us serve you better and to always come through, having like to get things done for your satisfaction. Yeah, I also want to say, on our next episode, we're going to be having an expert come on board to share with us how to know whether we should stay single. I mean, for the singles now, how do you know whether it is the time for you to stay single or you're ready to, you know, kickstart a love relationship with someone? So she's going to be coming on board next week to, you know, enlighten us on the things to know and how to live a happy single life, and also getting ourselves prepared for the life of, you know, being doubled, being in a relationship. So I'll see you. Make sure you do not miss it. I would like to say thank you so much for being a part of this show. For as many who talked on the show, yes, thank you so much. And for those taking out their time to listen to these, you guys rock. You're the real MVPs. So do have a great week, and do not forget that I am Oduayo. Take care. Bye. Thank you.